Yo, what's up, YouTube? As promised, here's the Grace Under Pressure review, since I forgot to put it in the damn ranking. Now, this album is the first without Terry Brown, I think, because he produced all of them. And his band pretty much had to produce the album themselves. And it's stuck right in the middle of what I call, like, the keyboard trilogy. Started with Signals, ended with Power Windows, even though Hold Your Fire and some of, like, Vital Signs off of Moving Pictures had keyboard. But this is very keyboard heavy, and this might be the darkest album lyrically that Rush has ever created. It deals with communism, Cold War, robotics, you know, taking over, androids, because in 1984, George Orwell, and, you know, Neil was a big reader, and even Grace Under Pressure is named after Courage, Grace Under Pressure quote or story, I'm not sure, of Ernest Hemingway, so there you go. And it starts off with just an early warning, and I always thought it was a keyboard heavy ding, 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 ding at the beginning and all throughout. And I know it's about the Cold War because he's like, red alert, red alert. And then, but Neil said it's about that. It's also about relationships and warning people, you know, growing apart and distant, you know. I see the tip of the iceberg and I worry about you. So it starts off with that. With that, it's a really great opener. And then After Image, about one of the producers, like the tape producer or tape coordinator at the studio in Montreal where they filmed. The guy died on his way leaving the studio, and I guess he was close with Neil, and he wrote the song about him. The opening line, suddenly you were gone, all the lives you left your mark upon. And it's kind of ironic because Neil did the same thing when he died. He left a mark upon not only the music world, drummers, but just, you know, lyrically and poets. And the video, ironically, shows him, the last shot of the video is him at the drum kit. He must have been the closest to the guy that died. And then comes my favorite song off the album, Red Sector A, and this might be even the darkest song on the record. It's about Geddy Lee's, I know, mother, but I'm not sure about his parents. His father was in it, but it's about concentration camps, and his mother was a Holocaust survivor. And it's the only song Rush, well, that I can think of, there's probably a couple, that Geddy doesn't even have a bass, it's just him and keyboard. And it's like, he talks about hearing the gunfire at the prison gate, you know, clenching the fist when bleeding, and, well, the wounds heal, and it's too late for his brother and father, but he must have help his mother survive. It's a really dark song, but it's my favorite. It's one of the better Rush songs for me, even though it is keyboard heavy. Just the lyrics and the image just of, you know, painting the images of the concentration camp survivors and how weeks turn into months and years, and it's really dark song. And then after that's The Enemy Within, which, like After Image and just an early warning, I think there was a video for it. And it's about personal struggles. It's kind of like a funky bass part, like Geddy was playing like a funky bass part. And, you know, it says, I'll never give up on my dreams, pretty much. It's being your harshest critic, I would know, because I'm always down on myself. I never, you know, believe in myself in anything. So this album, lyrically, really might be the Rush album that I resonate the most with, just because, you know, the whole, you know, critics and trying to fit in and all that with kid gloves. I don't try to fit in, but, you know, peer pressure and all that. And but The Enemy Within has a good fucking bass groove. And then The Body Electric, this is the album, it starts off the second side, The Body Electric. This is the album where Neil started experimenting with, like, jazz, reggae, funk-type drumming. And you can hear it also at the beginning, has that little funky bass intro again by Geddy and electric drums by Neil. And it's about AI and taking over the world. And you know, android. It talks about right at the beginning of the song, and he comes loose and escapes, and it's pretty much, I know it's probably based on, at the time, 1984, it's based on George Orwell, 1984, but also Terminator came out that same year, and you know, with all the AI shit people are doing today, it's very relevant. And yeah, it's, I'm like, Neil is ahead of his time. And then Kid Gloves is a, these next two, Kid Gloves is like a really poppy kind of song, happy sounding, but it's not really, put on your kid gloves, it's not easy being cool, put on your kid gloves. It's about peer pressure and fitting into society and all the people trying to tell you what to do and how to do it, everything. Even though it sounds poppy, but it's in like happy galloping song, but it's like I said, peer pressure, societal pressure. And then Red Lenses, this is the black sheep of the discography. Sort of like I Think I'm Going Bald, or you know, Ty Shan. It's very funky and reggae like drumming, so I'm sure it'd be fun to play, but the song is just really weird. It's an acquired taste. It's my least favorite off the album, but it has a cool beat to it. And it has to do with communism, you know, looking through red lenses, sort of like during the USSR, because they still had communism there. The red being like the color of the flag. And also he wrote that Heresy, one of my favorite songs off of Roll the Bones, about communism and living in communism at the end of communism. So yeah, and then Between the Wheels, which is one of their best deep cuts in my opinion, and it's just basically the wheels of life are rolling, you don't want to be caught in lost generation like I am. I've wasted my life pretty much up to this point. And it's saying you can go from boom to bust, from dreams to a ball of dust, and it can spin you around and then all of a sudden turn the other way, pretty much is what the song's about. And it's really heavy. The song is really one of Rush's heaviest songs. And in the beginning, it's like the whole, throughout the whole song, it's like ding, ding, ding. The keyboard's like, it's urgent, you know, live your life. Don't fuck up like I did and do nothing with your life. Basically, it's what this is, Between the Wheels. Caught between a rock and a hard place, like you said. Your dreams can turn to a bust and a ball of dust. So, yeah, like, and it also says a lost generation, I think, which is, I'm not sure, but now it's definitely Generation X, because they were passed up by the boomers and they're still in charge. So maybe that had a connection to it, but it's really heavy song and a great ending to this record, and it's another great message. So this album is maybe the darkest Rush album lyrically. It's just, there's no happy-go-lucky story or lyric here or any of this. So, and they basically produced it on their own, because the guy they had, it says Peter Henderson, but he came in later and, you know, just touched up some stuff. It was mostly produced by the band, because the guy they had pulled out the last minute. So, but that's just, that's Grace Under Pressure. Like I said, a lot of people love this record. I think it's really good. It's not in my top five, but it's definitely top 10 Rush. And like, it started off with Signals, then this one, and then Power Windows was way more, it's all keyboards pretty much. And then he went back to more, I mean, Hold Your Fire is kind of keyboardish, but it's not as many as those albums. And then Presto was back to guitar driven Rush. So that's a good review of Grace Under Pressure. I'll make a video soon. I'd probably give this, I don't know, 4 to 4.5 out of 5. Right. About 4, maybe 4.2 out of 5. It's really good. 4.25 out of 5. It's definitely in my top 10, like I said, probably around 6, 7, 8 in that. But that's Grace Under Pressure. Forgive me for not putting it in the ranking video, because I'm a dumbass. But I hope to make a video soon. I don't know what yet. What'll be the next one? Maybe it'll be a new release or something. So, as always, let me know what you think of this album. What's your favorite tracks off this album? Do you think it's the most darkest Rush album? And as always, please subscribe. I'll put a video here. And yeah, keep on rocking, YouTube, and I'll see you soon.